Again, now I will discuss some more examples of balancing chemical equation. Now, in this example, iron reacts with water to give iron oxide and hydrogen gas. So here you have to write this iron solid and then this water liquid state and this oxide, iron oxide as solid and this hydrogen as gas. Then now you have to find out which atom is the largest in number. Here iron 1 and here iron 3 and here 2 and here 2 and oxygen here 4 and here oxygen 1. So now you found oxygen has the largest number of atom in the equation. Then on the product side, that is on the right hand side, you can also call this side as right hand side for your easiness. Right hand side oxygen is 4 and on the left hand side oxygen is 1. So make it balance by putting what number? 4. Then after putting 4 in this on the left hand side water, your hydrogen number changes. Now you will not take hydrogen as 4 because already hydrogen has 2 in water, 2 atoms of hydrogen in water. Then 2 times this 2 times of hydrogen, it becomes 4 times. So 2, 4 are 8. In total, you have to count 8. Then on the left hand side, you have 8 atoms of hydrogen. Now you need to make your right hand side 8 atoms of hydrogen. So already you have 2. So to make it 8, now you put another 4. After putting 4, 4, 2 are 8. Now oxygen also balance and hydrogen also balance. Then lastly, what you need? You left only iron atoms. How many atoms of iron? 3 on the product side. Then now you will get on the reactant side 3. So just simply put 3. And finally, you balance your chemical equation. Very simple. So you observe carefully and listen carefully. And if you have any query, don't hesitate, just ask to me. And then this is easy. Easy in the sense that already the formula and the symbols are already given. But most often in exams, such questions is not coming. And then very often in exams, the question come to you is this type. That means from this statement, you need to convert into chemical equation and then balance it. So I'm picking up one very easy example. Hydrogen sulfide gas burns in air to give water and sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide gas. Hydrogen sulfide burns in air. So from this, you have to read the sentence carefully and then try to write which are the products and which are the reactants. So first you think hydrogen sulfide gas burns in air. So when some substance burns in air, they need oxygen. So that means if you read such a statement, burns in air, then always you have to bring oxygen because burning needs oxygen. That means they combined with oxygen. And hydrogen sulfide, you have to know the formula of hydrogen sulfide. Hydrogen here and sulfide, the valency 2 comes here. So H2S is the formula of hydrogen sulfide. And plus, we will put plus sign and then oxygen from here, burns in here, that's why we react with oxygen, O2. And the physical state of oxygen, that is gaseous state, we put Z. Then, which are the product? To give, that means what you get, to give. So to give water, now at the product side, you will write water, H2O water, and then water will be in the gaseous state. And you have to know that water can exist in three states, solid, liquid, gas. So here water that gives, it will be in gaseous state, and then sulfur dioxide gas, already mentioned, sulfur dioxide gas, so SO2 gas. Now, after writing the chemical equation, you need to balance. So now check it. Check it, the number of atoms on the number of atoms on the product side and the reactant side and product side. So now check it, hydrogen 2, hydrogen 2.